Hello everyone, myself Dr. Kalpana Sangwan, and today we are going to discuss an interesting case of type 2 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis with Drusens. Recently, a male patient in his 30s, totally asymptomatic, attended my OPD just to have a normal retina checkup, as he was recently diagnosed with type 2 diabetes mellitus. His sugars were above 400, HbA1c was around 8.5, and while doing fundus examination, I found something interesting. So let's discuss it. Welcome on board. Now you're looking at the fundus picture of both eyes. You'll be able to notice small yellowish-white rounded elevation of the RP, which are very much refractile and located quite temporal to the fovea. Apart from that, there were no signs suggestive of diabetic retinopathy. As usual, I investigated the patient further and asked him to get a complete hemogram along with peripheral smear, kidney function test and lipid profile. And patient, to much of my surprise, had abnormal kidney function test, for which I referred the patient to a nearby nephrologist. The patient came back to me with nephrologist opinion. I was surprised he underwent renal biopsy and diagnosed to have type 2 membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. So let's discuss about the pathogenesis of this condition and why would the patient have Drusen in the first place. So what are the conditions that predispose a patient to have type 2 MPGN, that is membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis? Physiological insults like post-streptococcal infections, throat infection, skin infections. Secondly, SLE. SLE itself can lead to lupus nephritis as well as type 2 MPGN. Thirdly, few percentage of patients with diabetes mellitus do develop these type of condition. It is a C3 mediated injury to the glomerulus. At the same time, no immunoglobulins are involved in this pathogenesis. So how does this complement mediated injury affects our retina? Complement mediated RP upregulation of few molecules like vitreoretinectin causes Bruch's membrane breakdown, which would further lead to deposition of Drusens. And Drusens are what? Nothing but hyaline byproducts of the Bruch's membrane. So how are these Drusens different from the one we find in ARMD? Let me tell you, they are very much similar. The location is also very much similar. These Drusens are found between the RPE basal lamina and inner collagenous layer of the Bruch's membrane. They are larger in size, dome in shaped. At the same time, they do support the pathogenesis that it's a complement mediated injury. And recently, so many drugs are under trial and under research which are targeting the complement in ARMD. As you can see in this picture, the Drusens are very much located in the RPE and the Bruch's membrane. You won't be able to see the Bruch's membrane very much clear in this picture, but yeah, somewhere you'll get an idea how is it planted somewhere there. Secondly, these Drusens are composed of cholesterol, amyloid B protein, vitreoretinectin and complement complexes, again supporting complement mediated injury. So how will a patient present to you? Patient will be totally asymptomatic, vision 20/20 or 6/6, very much younger in age, might be in second decade of his life or her life. There is no gender predisposition. At the same time, you will notice yellowish white refractile nodular elevations at the level of the RP, which you will notice very well in this picture as well. And this is a similar picture as AMD, except that location would be very much temporal to the fovea. So what are the clinical implications of this condition? As we have already learned, there will be antibodies formation against vitreoretinectin, C5, C5B9, amyloid B and TIMP3. What would these complements do? They will cause endothelial injuries and further cause chemotactic monocytic proliferation, which would lead to CNVM formation and further cause a decrease in the vision in future. So we have to look for that on subsequent visits. That's the reason we need to follow up the patient. So how do we approach such patients? First and foremost, ask the patient to review with you 4 monthly. And that is not the end of your job. you should tell the patient very assertively to visit a nephrologist as well as a physician for his diabetic as well as for his renal status. Thirdly, get a FAF and an OCT done every time patient visits to you to check for the number as well as the size of the drusens, whether they are increasing. At the same time, to check for CNVM, which is the single most reason for visual decline in such patients. So I hope you learned something new today, and thank you for paying your attention. Have a good day.